Within the past couple of weeks, there has been a lot of riveting reports coming out of the WWE, both positively and negatively. So let's talk about it. As Domicile News would say, get your tickets. We in for a ride. What's cracking, YouTube? This Legend Killer back in the building. Hey man, y'all know what's going on. I'm coming at y'all with another video. Now, I noticed Roman Reigns, Cody Rhodes, and The Rock situation. So we all know what happened on SmackDown, you know. Cody Rhodes and Roman Reigns had a face-off. He brought The Rock out, and SmackDown went off the air with them facing each other. Now, we all know what happened. Most of us know what happened during the weekend. But basically, on social media, this, you know, hashtag We Want Cody was trending. And, you know, you can't feel nothing but sympathy for Cody, because the fact that it seemed like for a moment that he was robbed out of a main event, you know, it sucked. But I already knew, I had it in the back of my head, and I still think this is going to happen. But I believe that this match will turn into a triple threat match, because if you look at WrestleMania 20, if you look at WrestleMania 30, you know, both shows have a triple threat match. So I believe that it's going to happen this year too. Not only that, in both of those events, a babyface came out as the winner of the main event in a triple threat match, and the opponents of said babyface were former tag team partners. Now, Roman Reigns and The Rock, of course, aren't tag team partners, or never were, but they have the same heritage, the bloodline. So that's very interesting. I just thought that would be interesting to share. And yeah, so I'm really rooting for Cody, and I think that he's going to be added into the match. And I just hope nothing but success and prosperity for him, because he has to finish the story, man. His story is very captivating and very inspiring. Not like outside of wrestling, you know. It's not just about him winning the title because his dad didn't do it. Nah, it's deeper than that. But you got to look at it from a greater standpoint. So that's that. The Rock was very heavily disregarded and booed on the internet and everywhere, you know. There was footage of fans booing him at a live event, as I'll show y'all here.
Boo.
Riveting footage shown by this fan. And he was also booed at an NXT PLE over the weekend, which was Wednesday. Great show, by the way. I seen it. This Thursday, they're going to be doing an event in Vegas, which is the WrestleMania 40 kickoff. And I believe that's where they're going to announce matches and stuff like that. I'm definitely going to be in tune watching that. I guess we'll have to see what, you know what I'm saying, what that holds for us. So yeah, that's that. And Cody Rhodes also showed his, you know, appreciation for the fans. And, you know, in this tweet right here, he says, "Appreciate the passion. God bless y'all. But trust me." And that just leads me to, you know, more faith and hope that Cody will be added into the match. And, you know, it's only up from here, y'all. So trust the process. Don't do too much, you know, which leads me to another thing. I've seen that a lot of the fans, you know, went crazy. Apparently, there was people out here sending death threats to not only The Rock, but his daughter, Ava, the NXT general manager. I think that's just stupid to do. Like, not only is it weird, bro, and not only is it corny to do, but it's like, come on, like, y'all gotta do better than that, bro. Y'all out here, you know what I'm saying, sending these hateful messages and posts to people that don't even know y'all exist, bro. And she tweeted out something, and I'm gonna read it for y'all right here. So she says, "Can y'all just leave me out of this? I'm busy running the show. Death threats over a situation I have nothing to do with. Be for real." So clearly she feels some type of way about that, justifiably. So, you know, she then went on to deactivate her account. And you know, I understand, you know, when you're under that fire for no reason at all too. Like, she did nothing wrong. She's not involved in this situation whatsoever. But, you know, people blow stuff out of proportion all the time, especially on the internet. And that leads me to another thing, the internet wrestling community, you know. over the years, you know, I've seen how toxic this wrestling fans can be, especially on the internet. But let me get some off my chest real quick. A lot of you, you know what I'm saying, be grown adults, bro. Y'all be in your 20s, bro, like mid-20s. And y'all just spend your whole day talking about and like just tweeting about a specific wrestler all day. You guys base your online persona, your presence, your you know what I'm saying, your whole personality off of another wrestler who doesn't know you exist 9 times out of 10. And when they do notice you, it was, let's be real, bro. When these wrestlers be noticing y'all because y'all be tweeting them and posting about them 100 times a day, it was bound to happen. You know what I'm saying? Like, come on, that's going to eventually pop up on their feed, on their timeline, whatever. So, you know what I'm saying? And then when y'all do get noticed by them, y'all treat it as like a life accomplishment. Like, oh my gosh, I got noticed, my favorite wrestler. But, you know, you gotta really, you know what I'm saying, be more mature than that, bro. That's not something you should be treating as like some sort of like trophy. You know what I'm saying? Like, I used to think that way too, but you know, I'm better than that. Like, come on, man. Y'all be grown adults and just basing off your whole online presence off of another wrestler or something like that. And it's just like, and that doesn't just go for wrestling fans. I'm sure there's countless people who do that with other celebrities. And to that, I just gotta say, let me let these things speak for me. Like, you cannot do that forever. Like, you better get it together. So that's well said. You know, you guys gotta do better than that. How I'm 16, about to be 17, by the way, 22 February 22. But how am I this young and I have less free time than y'all? Like, or do you guys be at work on your phone sneaking it like these? You know what I'm saying? Like, trying to hide your phone from your boss before he walks in the room. You know what I'm saying? And then when he do walk in, you grab that broom, you gotta sweep. You know what I'm saying? You gotta pull an S.Go, start sweeping. So I just wanted to say that real quick, man. But the internet wrestling community needs to chill sometimes, bro. Like, not sometimes, all the time. Y'all be doing too much. But I'm not gonna tell you guys what to and not to do, because obviously got no control of y'all. But just remember, I'm younger than you and I'm more wiser than you. Simp. But I digress. I just think a lot of people needed to hear that. Yeah, y'all sending death threats and stuff like that. Like, that's OD. Like, sad. And with Cody Rhodes, I think that, you know, it should definitely be a triple threat match between, or he should at least face Roman Reigns for the title, because I feel like Cody and Seth, like, nah, man. Like, we already saw Cody and Seth 3 times already, and we already saw it at WrestleMania as well when Cody returned in 2022. I don't think we need another Cody and Seth match anytime soon, let alone at Mania. In my opinion, I believe it should be Drew McIntyre facing Seth, and I believe he should have his WrestleMania moment then and there. So let me know what y'all think of that. But moving on to something a little more, you know, this is a more touchy subject. You know, it's a horrible situation, the Vince McMahon scandal. Now, I'm not gonna get into detail, but we all know what happened. I'm not gonna say what, you know, who was involved and what happened and the receipts. Now, we know, but let's just say this case, this scandal is very tantalizing. So I hope the truth comes to light and justice is served. And that's all I'm gonna say for now. I just don't understand how hard it is for some people to be a good person. Trust me, it's not that hard, y'all. Like, make wise decisions and use your brain at all times. Simp. Let's move on. CM Punk is back in WWE, or so we thought. Now, at the Royal Rumble, we all know what happened, man. Cody Rhodes won the Rumble, and I was very, you know what I'm saying, that was very unexpected, because I actually thought Punk was going to win for a second, but he didn't. It's all good, though. I love both Punk and Cody, which I'm going to talk about later in a little bit. During the match, CM Punk actually tore his triceps, and which I heard that it was due to a DDT from Drew McIntyre. I could be wrong, but that's just what I heard from reports. And it sucks, because I really want to see him versus Seth Rollins at WrestleMania, you know, potentially main event night one. And I believe that was even the plan already. That was already the plan. But, you know, this unfortunately has to happen. So we're going to have to wait till next year to see that, if at all it happens, you know. But it does suck. First match, first televised match, and he's already injured. Now, fortunately for me, I got to see him at the live event during the holiday tour. You know what I'm saying? The holiday tour back in December. So, you know, I was able to see him wrestle at least, you know, for the first time. And that really just puts a smile on my face, you know. Maybe we won't see him for another 4 to 6 months, but I'm glad that I was able to see him wrestle live, feel me? So that's that. Now, another thing that went down at the Royal Rumble, some good news for once in this video, you know, was the debut of Jay Cargill. Now, I'm so happy to see Jay fully making her debut on the WWE on the main roster. If you know me, you know I've always supported her ever since I discovered her 2 years ago, back when she was in AEW as the TBS champion. And she did great over there, so I hope that the creative team here notices and realizes what they have in front of them and use her to the best of her ability. I personally think she has the charisma, the aura, and the attitude of a top star, and I know I'm not the first person to think or say that. So that's that. Will she sign to SmackDown or Raw? That's the question right now. Now, me personally, I think she should sign to Raw because I think she should go after the World Championship, Rhea Ripley, and potentially dethrone her. You know what I'm saying? I would love to see that, bro. You know, I think it's about time Rhea Ripley loses that championship too. I ain't gonna lie, because the reign, if we being honest, is getting kind of stale. In my opinion, it's getting kind of stale. You know, Rhea has been on the top for at this point almost a year with that, you know what I'm saying, that title reign, but it's time to hang it up, man. And I would definitely love to see her versus Bianca. You know, we saw the face out at the Rumble. They teased it, you know, and I'm also a fan of Bianca, you know what I'm saying. I was able to see her against Asuka at WrestleMania last year, and that was a great match, and the fan reception was just all the way on top for me. But I wouldn't like to see the match with them two until next year, because I want to see it for the title and possibly the main event of night one. You know, Bianca Belair has main evented WrestleMania before with Sasha Banks. Great match, by the way. I remember watching it live and I was just amazed at how good these women really are at this, you know, at performing, you know. And I think that was a better main event match than the one at 35 with Ronda Rousey, Becky Lynch, and Charlotte Flair. You know, I feel like that match was cool to see a woman main event for the one time, but I feel like it wasn't fully there in terms of, you know, a crazy match that was, you know, that was memorable. But that's just my opinion. And off topic, but you know, I hope that one day, you know, when I fully come into the scene of pro wrestling, I can work with Cody Rhodes, CM Punk, and Jade, since they are probably my favorite wrestler nowadays, and they each inspire me in many different ways. Mainly Punk, since I've been a fan of his since I was, you know, little, you know, around the time I started watching wrestling, which is at this point probably over 10 years ago. You know, I just feel like my mentality and drive mixed with theirs will make for like a crazy faction, especially by the time I'm an adult. So it'll be really dope if I could meet and work with them all one day, but I'll speak more on that another time. This man Punk already got wrestling daughters. I could be his wrestling son. Simple. Lastly, I'm gonna briefly talk about something. This is WWE 2K24, the annual video game which drops next month. Now, the regular 2K24 game will drop on March 8, 2024 for PS5, PS4, Xbox Series S and X, Xbox One, and PC. So, y'all know, you know, somewhat enjoy, and I feel like 2K24 has a lot in store, so, yeah, I have a lot of, well, just to see them on the screen, you know what I'm saying, like, that's one thing, that's cool, you know what I'm saying, you just genuinely supporting them, and that's what I do. But if you're out here tweeting and posting your displeasure for every single thing, and talking bad about a wrestler and their fan base and this and that, you realize, bro, there's nothing good coming out of that. Yes, you're getting your thoughts out, you're getting your negativity out, bro. But like, what does that do for you, bro? Nothing. It does nothing for you in the long run. There's some wrestlers that I'm not a fan of. Not that I hate any, I don't hate any wrestler. I don't hate nobody. But I'm not gonna, you know what I'm saying, like, post hateful messages and stuff like that about them and say, oh, this wrestler sucks, I wish this happened to that, I wish this on them. Like, that's just, like, you get nothing out of that, bro. Like, come on, bro. Like,
it's really something I don't have time for, and I'm busy, and I'm trying to be productive in my life, and, you know, and also be positive. And when you think about it, there's nothing comes out of that. It's a complete waste of fucking time.
So you have time for that. You got to really reevaluate your life and your choices, because that's what's sad, bro. Like, come on. But I'm going to leave it at that. Let me know what y'all think of this video. And let me know if you want to see more videos like these in the future. I appreciate y'all for watching. If you made it to the end, thank you. More uploads coming soon. Stay tuned. I love y'all. Stay positive. And I'll see you on the next one, man. Stay in the zone. The killer zone.
I wish we could all get along and just enjoy the grounds.